going to be talking to those who life has just kicked in the gut. You know, just you've done everything right, you've done what you were supposed to do, and then somehow you just don't have the outcome that you were expecting. And it could be for some various reasons. Maybe you were saving yourself for the perfect man and then it just didn't happen. Or maybe perhaps you went to school, you got really great grades, you just still cannot find that dream job. You invested in someone or in a business and you just knew that this business was going to really be your next step for financial freedom. And instead, you know, it's just losing money. And so whatever it could be, maybe, you know, I don't know. It could be so many things, so I'm not going to go ahead and list 10. But I want to tell you, no matter what it is, what I'm about to tell you is still going to affect you, whatever your disappointment was. Because that's the thing about disappointments. They don't last forever. They're just a little temporary. They're really painful when they happen. And I want to tell you something that's really, when I found this out, I thought, wow, that is really something else. The actual pain from a disappointment only lasts about 98 seconds. I mean, seconds. The actual pain. What lasts really a long time is us rehashing it. Talking about it over and over and over and over again. That is where the problem is. We keep talking about it. We keep reliving it. We keep thinking about it. That's where the pain comes, and that's what paralyzes us from doing anything about our situation. And so what I want to talk to you today about is get your groove back. Yep. Get it back. Get back on that horse, or, you know, even if it's not getting back on doing the same thing, but now make a decision that today is the last day that this thing will control you. And how do you begin to do that? Some of the things that you can do is just start to look for happy moments in the day. In every single day that you have, there is something that's happy that's happening. I don't know. And you say, oh, I don't know about your day. I don't know how horrible it happened. The worst thing could have happened. Even just look for good things. You have to look for the good. Sometimes it just doesn't like stand there and wave at you, hey, I'm good. And sometimes we just have to look for it. You know, why don't you try new challenges? Get excited about a new challenge. Think about something that you can be doing and just start building up excitement around this new challenge. Just that excitement alone would start changing the way you feel about yourself, about what you can do, your capacity, your capabilities. A lot of times we really get stuck in this place of, oh, I failed last time, and so the next thing is going to be a failure. So go out there and start thinking of new challenges and start taking them on. And because even if any new challenge you take on, no matter what happens at the end of it, you learn something. You stretched yourself. That in itself is something to be excited about. And then I want you to measure what you call success. What are you calling success? Is your success because of what you thought where you're supposed to be, because of what's going on with your friends, or is it perception of your success depending upon how many people give you accolades, how many people say give you attaboys, or is it merely because your success is something that you have planned to do and you actually did it, you achieved it, you obtained it, you have it. Totally different way of measuring success versus, oh, we all finished school together, how come I didn't get a job? They got a job before I got a job. How come she's getting paid that? And so I want you to think about that. I want you to have confidence in the midst of your adversity, of whatever's going on in your life, knowing without a shadow of doubt, this is a temporary situation. It will pass, and there is something amazing that's going to happen on the outside. There is something waiting for you that you cannot even imagine, but you got to get past this. You got to move through this. And even if someone has to crawl you, ask someone to help you. But you can't be stuck in it and still see what's going to be on the other side. You got to get to that other side. And so in doing that, just take care of yourself during this time. This is not the time to sabotage your credit by buying all kinds of things you don't need. This is not the time to sabotage your weight by eating stuff that's going to make you feel bad about yourself at the later. This is not the time to go and get some new haircut or new hairstyle that you never thought about. This is a time to do things that are self-care for yourself. And in doing those things, do everything towards the destination and the desire of the thing that you actually wanted. Anything that's going to move you away from that, let it go. Be focused. Get exactly what you want. Get your groove back. Have a good day.